With clean hands and gloves, clean the area around the fuel filler cap and remove the fuel filler cap to depressurize the fuel system. Then set the cap back in place without securing it to prevent fuel tank contamination. Before we begin, we need to understand that at no point should fuel be added to the system anywhere or anytime except at the fuel tank. The 2021B fuel system is a precision-controlled system, which is needed to meet emission regulations, and even minor contamination can result in operational issues. Next, clean the area around the fuel filter module. When the filter caps are removed, dust and debris can be stirred up and contaminate the fuel system. Draining the currently filled fuel filter must be done according to proper procedure. Begin the removal of the fuel filters by loosening them one at a time until the O-ring seal just becomes fully visible. Absolutely no power tools, air or electric, should be used to remove these caps. This might damage the caps, but at this point, an additional risk is loosening the cap too far and cross-contaminating the fuel system. Keep in mind that both covers must be loosened to the point where the O-ring is fully visible within 30 seconds from the beginning of loosening the first cover. Loosen the primary filter cap first. The O-rings for both the primary and secondary filter caps must be fully visible within 30 seconds of one another. Once both O-rings are visible, you must wait a full 2 minutes before doing any more to remove the filter caps. This will allow the currently installed filters to completely drain and prevent cross-contamination from the dirty side to the clean side of the filter housing. Clean the drain plug valve and the area around it. Prevent dirt from entering the fuel system. Loosen the drain plug a few turns until it begins to drain collected water and fuel. If no water or fuel comes out, check to see if the hole in the drain is clogged. When the filtration module is fully drained, close the drain plug. Dispose of the collected water and fuel properly. After waiting the full 2 minutes, rotate each of the filter caps by hand to remove the caps and filters from the fuel filter module. Once the caps and filters are removed from the fuel filter module, the filters need to be removed from the caps. This is done by rotating the filter clockwise with the filter end of the filter and cap assembly toward you, then pulling the filter away from the cap. Before installing the new fuel filter, remove the cap O-ring and lubricate the O-ring recess with fresh engine oil. Now replace the cap O-rings and lubricate the new O-rings with fresh engine oil. The new filters are installed by first snapping them onto the cap by sliding them into position, then rotating them counterclockwise. You will feel them snap or lock into place. Be sure to lubricate the cap O-ring, the lower filter O-ring, and the standpipe seal with clean engine oil before setting the filter assembly back into the fuel filter module. Now screw the filter and cap assemblies into place by hand. Then use a torque wrench to tighten the caps to 55 Newton meters, which is 487 inch-pounds or 41 foot-pounds. Next comes the recommended priming procedure. The recommended procedure for this new system is to prime the system by hand, using the hand priming pump. Here's what you will feel or sense as you prime the system. Within a few strokes of the pump, you should begin to feel fuel starting to move through the hand pump. How soon depends on how thoroughly the fuel filter module was drained. Then you will feel nothing as you pump. No resistance, no fuel flow. After about 70 strokes, you will begin to feel a little back pressure in the pump. This back pressure will increase and decrease a little as you continue pumping. At about 170 strokes, the back pressure will increase significantly, and the fuel filters will feel filled. The number of strokes and the amount of time it takes to prime the filters and the fuel system will vary a little. But the path to the most efficient priming is to adhere to one important rule. Any piston pump has an optimum reciprocating frequency. For the manual priming pump, this frequency is an ergonomically sound 60 to 100 strokes per minute, or about 1 to 1.5 strokes per second. Once the system is primed, tighten the fuel tank filler cap and try starting the engine. If it does not start within about 15 seconds of cranking, use the hand priming pump for about 30 seconds and try starting again. Repeat this as many times as necessary until the engine starts. Once the engine is started, Do not rev the engine. This will do nothing to help the process and might actually slow the process. Allow the engine to idle for a full 5 minutes while inspecting for fuel leaks. Once the 5 minutes has passed, the engine is now ready for additional maintenance work, or for test driving the vehicle, or for returning the vehicle to the customer.